as the filing of the certificates of candidacy came to a close at exactly 5 p.m. on Wednesday. Voters might have gotten the sense that the choices for senator are basically more of the same, and never mind the political or legal baggage that could weigh heavily on their candidacy. The three former senators accused of pocketing millions of pesos in people's money through the pork barrel scam are running once more, regarding a victory as a form of vindication. 94-year-old former Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile made a personal appearance at the Commission on Elections on Wednesday to refile his COC.
Who knows? I might outlive the others who are in the Senate today. I'm not saying that I am immortal, but only God knows.
Of the senatorial hopefuls being considered in the administration ticket, perhaps only two can be regarded as clearly the president's candidates. But to the president's critics, former Philippine National Police Chief Ronald Bato de la Rosa and Presidential Assistant Christopher Bongo are considered enablers in an administration that has been defined mainly by the sheer brutality of its war on drugs.
Let the people judge. If you think the president is doing his job, vote for us. If you think he's not doing his duties, support for the Filipino people to decide that.
One of the fiercest defenders of Duterte's drug war is former human rights lawyer Harry Roque. It's a role he has embraced despite heavy criticism, all for the sake supposedly of his political ambition. Roque joined the senatorial race on Wednesday.
These are people who probably are ingit to the bones, no, and I don't really mind them.
The 2019 election campaign will also be defined by the Marcoses' effort to firmly re-establish their power and influence on the national stage more than 30 years after their fall. Ilocos Norte Governor Amy Marcos is seeking a Senate seat, while her brother is still contesting his loss in the last vice presidential election. But martial law victims and human rights defenders are making their voices heard in an opposition slate fielding a Diokno, a Tanyada, and an Aquino. Some of those who filed their COCs offered themselves as alternatives in a tight race expected to be dominated by the usual politicians.
Mayroong espasyo para sa mga bagong boses, sa mga bagong tinig na may kredibilidad. At sa tingin ko, pwede nating ibigay yun sa taong bayan. Hindi pa tayo kilala, pero pag nalaman nila ang ating istorya at ang ating kakayahan, sa tingin ko, makikinig sila sa atin at ilalagay tayo sa balota.
The days devoted to the filing of candidacy certificates provided voters a glimpse of election campaign's Philippine style. Loud, colorful, festive, which unfortunately can also provide an easy cover for some candidates who may be wealthy and popular, but with no real competence and qualification to show. Christian Esguerra, ABS-CBN News.